Hi everyone, this is Mr. Po, welcome to a new video. You probably remember, guys, that I had Matilda, a very beautiful female betta fish, and I really liked this fish. She was very playful, but unfortunately she passed away this afternoon. That's very sad for me, very depressing, because you get attached to bettas. Everybody knows who kept betta, they know that these are very intelligent fish from the point of view of a human being. They are curious, they are playful, they are highly intelligent, they recognize you, they are always ready to interact with you, you know, they see you and they get, you know, very excited, etc. And when such things happen, you feel first of all responsible for all that, and the next, you know, you feel sad because sometimes you just cannot do anything. And the fish suffers, it dies, and that's not the most pleasant feeling because you get attached to this fish, you know, no matter how maybe surprisingly it may sound, especially for the people who didn't keep betta fish or aquarium at all. But fellow aquarists and, you know, fish keepers, they probably understand what I'm talking about right now. Well, the reason why it happened, she had columnaris. And you know, guys, especially, you know, fellow fish keepers, you know that this is just number one probably killer disease, you know, in aquarium. And I noticed some changes in scales of Matilda back in June, probably in the summer, but I thought that it was a fungal disease, so I put some erythromycin in the water in aquarium and everything stayed okay. But just 2 weeks ago the situation got really worse. You know, the fish lost colors, she was getting very inert, not active at all. She didn't take a lot of food. She suffered. I put her in a quarantine tank. I have just removed it, you know, and cleaned it. I tried to treat her. I put some erythromycin, metronidazole, salt in order to kill bacteria in water, some healing medicine, but unfortunately Matilda didn't respond to this treatment and she died. It was very painful to watch, you know, but you see, sometimes this stuff happens and sometimes you cannot do anything already. Well, you know, it's always like possibility when you bring a new fish home that they can carry some disease. And probably Matilda was carrying this columnaris disease in her for a long time and it was just killing her slowly. Because the water she was living in was really okay. And that's what happened. And you know, I'm just very probably devastated even after that, because so far I had negative experience of keeping bettas. I had two bettas before. It didn't turn out very good because I had, you know, not so much experience. I was an inexperienced fish keeper, you know, if we talk about proper fish keeping. I was trying, but you know, it was not the most successful result, and I thought that this time I would provide her with the best conditions, but unfortunately, you know, sometimes such things happen. And columnaris can kill fish very easily and very fast, and you cannot deal with it, you know, no remedy can help. Well, that's what happened. When we keep any pet, no matter if it is small or not, no matter if it is fish, bird or anything else, anyone else, you know, you always feel responsible for those pets. But when we talk about betta fish, it's twice unpleasant because it's an intelligent fish and, you know, you can interact with this fish like a pet fish, you know what I'm saying? So that's, you know, disappointing. And I think that I will no longer keep any bettas again because I just don't want to experience the same traumatizing, you know, moments again. So I will probably stick to some, you know, other fish, hardy fish probably. Yes, you know, bettas are hardy too, but the problem is, you know, they are fighters. They fight to the end, they live to the end, they stay active to the end, but they have sometimes diseases and they kill them slowly, you know, it's just a matter of time. For example, they may have fungal disease, they may have bumps, they may have cancer, you know, which is almost the same as bumps, and they may also, you know, be susceptible to such diseases as columnaris. So when it happens, you know, you just probably may try to treat this, you know, fish, or maybe, you know, just try to help this fish somehow. But the result, the end will be, you know, again, very saddening and devastating and, you know, disappointing. And you will feel, of course, sorry for this beautiful better. So, well, that's it. That's why, guys, if you want to keep any new fish, any fish at all, you of course need to do a lot of research, because even experienced fish keepers, even fish keepers who know what they do, sometimes they may fess up with that things, with that thing as well, and not everything you know may depend on you entirely. There are some things that are always out of control in this hobby. This is just nature, this is, you know, microbiology, so you know that's what happens sometimes. So, well, thank you so much for watching this, guys. Stay safe and see you next time.